Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. On today's episode, let's talk about the orientation switch on your iPad or iPhone and why you may think your device is stuck in either horizontal or vertical mode. So this is a question I get pretty often. Somebody says that either their iPhone or their iPad will no longer switch between vertical and horizontal mode or orientation, and they think perhaps something is wrong. And what's happened, in fact, is that they've accidentally turned on orientation lock. So here I'm looking at my iPhone 6 Plus and I'm looking at it in vertical orientation. And if I wanted to switch to, say, horizontal orientation, it would look like this. So you can see if I got stuck in one of these two modes and it didn't switch anymore as I move the device physically, I would be a little concerned. Now note that the home screen on older iPhones, smaller screen iPhones, do not switch to horizontal orientation, but other apps like games and, of course, Safari and Mail, they do switch. So, for instance, if you're using an iPhone 5S, you'll notice it doesn't switch to horizontal mode at all on the home screen, whereas the iPhone 6 Plus does, and it does on the iPad as well. So what most people don't realize is they probably inadvertently turned on the orientation lock. Now, the orientation lock is a simple setting that allows you to keep your iPhone or iPad in either vertical mode or horizontal mode no matter how you turn it physically. So to turn it on and likewise to turn it off, you want to bring up Control Center, which means you swipe up from beyond the bottom of the screen to bring up Control Center. And you can see the orientation lock at the upper right. It's the little padlock with the circle arrow around it. If I tap it to go on, you can see it tells me Portrait Orientation Lock is on. Likewise, if I were already in horizontal mode and I were to turn it on then, it would say Horizontal Orientation Lock on. Either way, it's going to keep the orientation of the moment when you turned on Orientation Lock. Now, no matter how you turn your iPhone or what you do, it's always going to stay in this orientation. So this is very useful, say, if you want to read or play a game while you're reclining or lying down in bed, or perhaps you very often put your iPhone or iPad down on a flat table and find that you are always using it one orientation or the other and don't want to be bothered with lifting it up and physically moving it to the right orientation. So it's useful, but a lot of people don't realize when they've turned it on, because you see nothing really happened to the screen. It stayed the same. It's just that little indicator there. So you may have accidentally turned it on, not realized it, and then all of a sudden, minutes, hours, or days later, you notice you can't switch the orientation. Just go and check your orientation lock here and turn it off to be able to go and switch again between vertical and horizontal mode. Now, one thing to note is if you're using an older iPad, not the current iPad Air 2, but something older, you've got a side switch, and the side switch by default is the mute switch. However, you can go into settings and change that to be the orientation lock switch. Now, you may have inadvertently done that while playing around, and then it's even easier to accidentally turn orientation lock on or off. So if this is set so that the side switch is the orientation lock switch, then bringing up Control Center is simply going to show the mute switch in place of the orientation lock. So it kind of toggles between the two of them. So this is another place to check if you're having trouble locating the orientation lock switch on the Control Center on an older iPad. Now, if you have an iPad Air 2 that does not have a side switch, then you'll actually see both the orientation lock and the mute button in the Control Center.